what is the truth? Example, you have seen in swimming pools that there are a jump darts in different levels. You have seen how children play and jump to the pool different there, but not all of them. There are some children who have encouraged for that. Even other children cheers them. The parents cheers them to jump, but few returns. The risk is that they don't try again. This example is like going to the church and listen, but don't step in Jesus' life. I think that one of the reasons is there an enough knowledge or that they discuss with others. Sometimes people are rejected from a church. They try with other churches, but they become rejected. Don't give up the church. Give up. The church is God's house. But for you who have accepted Jesus as your Lord, then trust Him, and it is important to obey His commandments and lead others to do that too. Do not return, for it is not good. Be kind and helpful and a good example to make Jesus proud and happy, because Jesus gave His life to free us from our sins. He suffered, crucified, to wash our sins with His blood. Understand and feel His love. With baptism, you enter to Jesus' imperium and become a member of His society. By reading the Bible, you learn how to live at cross, to be a Jesus, because Jesus lives in you and you in Him. Find the Christ philosophy. Pray that Jesus and Holy Spirit help you understand and write the words in your mind and your body, which is a temple. Amen. Holy Spirit watching over our belief and action. When we are in Christ, Holy Spirit watches our actions and belief. You can ask Him for support and help, and He does, because He also will you please Jesus and the God. Amen. Jesus loves more because we believe and trust on Him, even it is unseen. But God has made many people eye-minded, and they can see Jesus and also miracles in no time. In Jesus' time, those people who didn't believe Him, even they saw a lot of His miracles and heard His teaching, remained in their temporary life. Those people who returned from Jesus weren't with Him. Maybe they hadn't any good guidance because they didn't accept Jesus as their shepherd. Be careful that you don't be a Christ without being holy. It is important, and ask Jesus to don't leave you alone during the journey. Each time you don't feel His presence, seek Him and pray the good. Amen. Those who return from Christ when they were Christ cannot find repentance anymore. There is no life in those people anymore. My question is that it appeared a secular period when people lost their belief to the God and Jesus. We are living now in a post-secular period when people return to the churches with new ideology about Christ, while it is not the real ideology and philosophy of Christ. Are these people find repentance? Jesus answered me that they are at this left side when He comes again in this world. With Jesus, you have eternal life and have peace in this world. Jesus is love and kind and gentle and generous. He is our Father. Then we must heritage His wonderful hymn. God doesn't forget our community with Jesus and each other. Do not doubt on the God and Jesus, even the storm comes in our life. Try to stay strong and see it straight and wait until the storm passes through and see the sun and its flash. Sometimes you have a feed to feed yourself temporarily. Of course, it is not sin. Fight for the rights and truth, even it costs you. Leave your problems under the cross and let Jesus crush them. Amen. Kindness to others is kindness to the God and Jesus. Love each other, so is loving the God and Jesus. Praise the God and Jesus. Expand hope with strength from the God and Jesus, and trust them in the best equipment in your life. Stay holy as like as Jesus is. Each time you feel bad, very quick seek your holy feeling. You together with Jesus, who is living in you, work on your feeling. Seek the solution in the Bible and find yourself as you should be. Don't forget that you receive promises. It is heritage, which is God's grace, making us holy. Amen. When you are positive and do good, it is Jesus in you helping you do. Then you see always Jesus in all your good actions. We pray each day that God, let your angels work on me so others adore you, and also we pray, Jesus, make my life as a window so that your light shines through. Hallelujah. Amen. If you are an active Christian, then your holiness is very low, because you are busy with the slavery. Even you are busy in your life with job and family, you must have Jesus with you and your mind. Then the result of your daily job is beautiful. The reason that people leave Christ is their weak belief. People ask for favor from Jesus and it don't happen. They become disappointed or dumb. Now the question is, if such a people become forgiven, my answer is they think that they with Jesus they have perfect life, while it is not true. You together with Jesus make your life perfect. It doesn't mean that you are going to be a king or get a whole world for yourself. You get what you need, and it must make you happy and pleased. It stands in the Bible that people get their desired heart. Many good and nice people have had a hard life because of others make their life hard for them. But by your faith to the God and Jesus, you live in peace and safety and healthy. When you continue trusting Jesus, who is in you and you in him, you face all God's promises, and you have guaranteed a place in the God's kingdom. As long as God and Jesus are generous, you should be too. It doesn't always mean economically. It can be in another way, like teach people and let them live free and healthy. The Bible's answer is, we need an outer power to help us stay balanced and have a peaceful and restful life. Hebrews 6, part 9. God and Jesus don't forget the good things you do, but you must have faith and trust God and Jesus for their timing. Part 11. If you are purposeful and serious in what you do, you can be succeed. If you lose something or someone, divorce. By praying and good advising, you keep them. Of course, if someone dies, you cannot get him or her back, but you have always their good spirit on you. You can wonder what is the rate of or level of purposefulness. And seriously, I should have to get successes. Have hope and belief and love and trust. Then you receive promise. But do not be lazy. You must try. God promised Abraham in his holy name and gave his kingdom that we are the generation. When we promise, we swear in the name of God, who is the Most High, and God promised Abraham in his holy name. You must have patience as the same as God has patience on us. Of course, we haven't so long time to live, but when you ask God and Jesus for a favor, you get in right timing. Amen. When Abraham went through the temptation, God sent his love to Abraham's generation. Then we, Jesus' children, have God's grace and mercy and forgiveness over us. Part 19, Jesus has put his anchor in secure way, that no storm or hurricane can destroy his ship, his imperium. Jesus became crucified, and the result was that God put away that cover between us human on the earth and heaven. Hallelujah. Amen. Hebrews 7 part 15. How should I know that I am safe at the end? With your strong faith, you wholly are secure. With your trust, you believe on the truth. Your safety is already at cross. Of course, if you have a pure Christian life. Hebrews 7 part 20. God swore that Jesus is the Most High and eternal praise. When we die, Jesus is there for us to receive us. You must have a strong connection with Jesus. Connection is like your heart, which keeps you alive. Always trust in God's timing. He has patience, so you do. Do not doubt. Only believe strong and have hope. Amen. Hebrews 6 part 19, it talks about greater than. In any situation, you find Jesus greater than it. When you are unhappy, happy, having trouble, having success, having party, having mourning, having eating, sick, and so on, if you call or seek Jesus, the problems are eliminated and joys become more joyful. The key in this part is that when something is better than the other, it produces better. Example, foundation is better than wastewater. Seaside is better than building site. Of course, Jesus and God are greater than anything else. That is because when you realize that Jesus is in you and you in him, everything you do is good. When you are in the end, you are saved because Jesus is there to accept you. Jesus completes God's will. Hebrews 7 part 1 to 13 is comparison between Abraham and Melchizedek, MS, who was also prophet and God's chosen. Which one is greater? Yes, everybody who knows about Abraham tells that Abraham. Now we read in scripture the titles of MS, the king of justice, the king of peace. Even it doesn't stand about his relatives, he remains like God's son and as high priest. This means that Jesus, who is God's son and the Most High eternal priest, belongs MS root. Even Abraham gave MS the tennis court. Levi, who belongs to Abraham, also confirmed all those who become priests by Levian get tennis court. MS blesses Abraham. Then he had his this power. Always the greater can bless the other. Now, we see that MS is greater than great Abraham. Not because of only these identities, but because of God decided so. And of course, Jesus is MS road, is greater than Levi, who was great in Abraham road. It doesn't stand in the scripture about MS death, but it stands about the priest's death. Then there is different between priest in MS route and priest in Abraham route. Observe, it stands that MS lived in many years and he returned after 1,000 years and met Abraham. Levi gave MS tennis course because Abraham had done, which means that MS is greater than Levi too. When we accept and believe that someone is greater than the other, then everybody in his route is greater too. The priesthood in MS route are also greater than the priesthood in Levi's route because of the perfections and integrities caused by their job. Observe that priesthood doesn't cover the false priests, churches, and prophets. current generation are living due to laws means that they are legalized, led to the life. When Jesus' generation live in life, which is Jesus, therefore the life is greater than the laws, which are great. That laws are God's words, which must be obeyed, and that God's words is life when you obey. Legalized and perfection is parallel, but because of the evils and demons put earthly laws to dominate the God's law. God sent other prophets to defeat demons. God sent us Jesus, his son, and starts and completes the perfection period. If Jesus had an earthly father, then his commandments became legalized. But Jesus is heavenly and he exists from the beginning. Then his commandments are perfection. Hallelujah. Amen. God's words, eternal life, is greater than the laws. Perfection is greater than legalized. Jesus' blood over the cross washes our sins. Therefore, legalized is canceled. Then live as Christ and be Christ. Amen.